Hey yo, Channel Fireball people, you're back with me, HotChoc, and today, Silver Tempest is getting very close to being released. So I thought, how about we look at the most expensive Silver Tempest cards out there in Japan? So we have an idea of if he was to pack any of these cards, hopefully in a pre-release, we know we should be onto some money, baby. Let's keep it moving. Right then, so coming in at number 5, for all you max rarity players out there, you might have to start emptying your wallet if you want to play Regidrago, because Regidrago V alternate art is coming in at 6,980 yen, which translates to £41, and I'll tell you what, let me just quickly get that in USD for you as well, $47. This is a pretty cool looking card, right? He's just sitting there on the tree, minding his own business. But Regidrago is going to be probably a tier 2 deck, maybe something along those lines. Maybe even tier 1, because the Regidrago V-Star lets you use any dragon types from your discard pile's attacks as its attack, meaning you can use some crazy combinations, such as like Flygon V, Garchomp V, Duraludon V, Max. Any of those, the Dragonite from Silver Tempest as well. You can use any of his attacks as his attack. What's the word I'm looking for here? Super versatile. Oh my goodness, it's early in the morning. Super versatile. So yeah, cool looking. Anytime you have playable alternate arts, the price always just goes all the way up there. So if you manage to get any of these in a pre-release, make sure you get that in a nice little sleeve right there and look after him. Unless you're looking to play the deck, in which case, put it in a sleeve, look after him, and then go find three more. Yeah, I'll tell you, you max rarity players, oh boy. Yeah, so that's our number 5 most expensive card from Silver Tempest. So number 4. So coming in at number 4, I was actually surprised about this one. It's Unknown V alternate art. Now, looking at it here, you know, it looks kind of cool. Looks like it could be in the ruins of Alpha, any kind of ruins, you know what I mean? They're just flying around, but not a particularly playable card. Neither is the V-Star. I can't even remember what they do, but they're not that great. But yeah, so the price is coming in at 7,480 yen, which converts to $51. And that, to me, sounds like a lot for a card that has no playable value coming out of the set. Let me just see what Unknown V does. So Unknown V has two attacks. The first attack for one psychic. Your opponent's active is now confused. That's not very good. And then for 3 colors energy, you do victory symbol. If you have exactly 1 prize remaining when you do this attack, you win the game. So you basically take a prize card if you're at 1 prize card. But there is a V-Star as well. Let's see what that does. So the V-Star, I'm laughing because it's not that great. Try power for 1 energy. Flip 3 coins. Do 70 for each heads. So pretty bad. And then for 3 energy we have Star Cipher. Until this Pokemon leaves play, it gains an ability that the effect of all your opponent's weakness is now psychic. So that's kind of interesting. You make all your opponent's Pokemon weakness psychic as long as this unknown stays in play. And I'm sure there's some probably some crazy combinations that we can think of. I'm sure I'll try and make some funny decks with this as well. The big problem I see with this is that this Pokemon has to stay in play. So if it gets KO'd, your V-Star power is now, well, your V-Star attack, I should say, because it's actually an attack, is useless. So I don't predict this to be doing anything in the realms of doing well at tournaments, but hey, it's a cool looking card, the V alternate art. It's a cool looking card. It's a kind of, I like the historic looking card that might be telling a little bit of a story, unknown some of those really, what's the word, unknown secretive Pokemon. So yeah, that's Unknown V alternate comment number 4. What's at number 3? Right, coming in at number 3, this is no surprise to me, and if you know Silver Tempest, it shouldn't come as a surprise to you, because we're looking at Lugia V-Star in that golden rarity, which is an absolute gorgeous looking card. I don't think all the V-Star Pokemon suit the gold borders, right? Giratina does, off the top of my head, and I think Lugia V-Star just suits it perfectly, maybe because the contrast of the gold and Lugia's white wings is just mwah. Anyway, let me talk to you about Lugia V-Star then. So, could be the poster boy of the set, in my opinion. Could be the best Silver Tempest deck to be released. It's probably between Lugia and Regidrago. And I think at this moment in time, Lugia is looking like the better deck. So, Lugia, for 4 energy. You do Storm Dive, which is 220 damage, and then you remove a stadium in play. 220 for 4 sounds dreadful, because it kind of is. However, if we look at Lugia's V-Star ability, Assembly Star, during your turn, you can get 2 colorless Pokemon from your discard pile and put them straight onto your bench, but they can't have a rule box. What this means is that you can grab out stage 2s and stage 1 colorless Pokemon from your discard pile and put them straight into play. This works perfectly with the new Arceus from this set, which lets you attach 2 special energies from your deck to your Pokemon. That's insane. So the idea is Lugia plucks out 2 of these Archeops and you can fling into play 4 special energies and get to rocking. What this means is that you can use stuff like Powerful Energy, which gives you an extra plus 20. You can use create stuff like Auroras, you can use other attackers. And in combination with Powerful Energy and Choice Belt, this 220 actually starts to Oko V-Star Pokemon fairly easily. So yeah, Lugia V-Star Ultimate Gold Art is absolutely gorgeous. It's gonna be good. I mean, it's gonna be playable, very strong, and looks gorgeous. And you know what? I guess it's a collector Pokemon as well. Lugia's one of those popular legendary collector Pokemon. Anytime you've got a card that in all 4 of those categories, it's gonna be expensive. So speaking of expensive, it comes in at 9,500 yen, which is $65. So we're starting to get up there into the crazy expensive cards now, right? We've still got 2 more though. What's at number 2? Right then, so coming in at almost 4 times Lugia V-Star Gold's price, we have Candice Full Art, which is a Full Art supporter card, which lets you look at the top 7 cards of your deck, reveal any number of water Pokemon and water energies, and put them straight into your hand. So this probably, even though it sounds a little bit crazy, right, getting a ton of water energies and Pokemon into your hand, this might not actually be that great. As funny as it sounds, because water has so much support, right? You got Palkia, Capacious Bucket, Melanie, you got all these options. And I don't really think Candice fills, I can't see a use case for Candice in the sort of higher tier meta decks, such as like a Kyurem or Palkia. However, this could be pretty good in that Swim Freely deck, actually, now I think about it. So maybe Swim Freely has now got a little bit of a buff. But like I said, Candice is coming at 4 times the price almost as the Lugia. So 35,000 yen or an absolutely back-breaking 240 US dollars. That is insane. I guess Pokemon players must really like, or Pokemon players slash collectors must really like Candice. I don't like her that much. I would not be spending personally anywhere near the $240 on this card. But hey, if you're a set collector, full art set collector, anything like this, then you're gonna have to get this card on there. But we have one that's higher than Candice, and it is super, super playable. Oh, okay. This next card, our number one card. I just did the conversion from yen to US dollars. And I literally just went, I was scared. I was so scared of that number that Google just punched out at me. But let me show you the card first. The most expensive card from Silver Tempest at the minute, according to Japanese cartels, is Lugia V Ultimate Art. Now, I am an absolute fan of this card, let me tell you. Reminds me of one of my other favorite artworks, the Gyarados from Ancient Origins, where you got the fisherman trying to reel in the Gyarados, and the Gyarados is having none of it. This is almost like calling back to there, where you've got the fisherman like, oh my goodness, what have I just done? And then you've got Lugia like, yo, boy, what are you doing? What are you doing, man? You better get that boat away from me quick, because I'm about to aero blast you away. I like the cards that tell stories, and especially the way that this picture is. You can sort of see how big Lugia actually is in comparison, like the boat and the person. So everything about the artwork is just, I love it. However, one thing I don't love about this card is it's priced. So this card comes in at 84,000 yen, which when you do the little Google translate or your conversion almost, I should say, that comes in at 570 US dollars. I'm not 100% sure what a booster box price is over there in America, but I'm fairly certain you could get a case of Silver Tempest with that money. So if you pull one of these bad boys at your pre-release, you better look after it. Put it in a sleeve, put it in a vault, lock it up, bury it underground, build something over. You got to look after this card because there's going to be a nice one right there. And if you get a good little PSA, you got yourself a little deposit on a house, baby. So yeah, let me know what you think about this list. If you're going to buy any of these cards when Silver Tempest drops, make sure you go do it at Channel Fireball and use my code HotChoc, okay? But thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.